So today, we are headed out to Arkansas's local drift venue. Fun fact, Arkansas doesn't have a local drift venue. We have a go-kart track that the owner is nice enough to let us come out and slide on sometimes, and that's kind of what we do. We have events out there every now and again, but mainly what we use it for is days like today, where a small group of people get together, they pay to rent the track for the day. So you have the whole track to yourself with like four or five cars, and you go out there to really shake down the car before the year starts. And that's kind of what our goal is today. I've got a lot of new parts on the car. It has new tie rods. It has a new steering rack. It has new steering rack bushings. And the steering has recently also been recentered. So it should feel way, way different. I also have a hydraulic e-brake. And it's the first time I've been able to drive with an e-brake in over a year. So I'm excited for that. But yeah, we're just going to shake down the car. We're going to show up and kind of see what happens and get some really saucy tandems in. All the guys that are coming today are really good drivers, so that's exciting. But anyway, yeah, today's gonna be a good day. I'm excited. This place is actually pretty cool. There's a dirt track right there, and then our track is right here. So when they have dirt track events, it's just, it's kind of cool because, you know, we're right next to each other and we get a lot of attention from all the dirt track crowd. But honestly, there is nothing quite like having a whole racetrack to yourself for a day. If your local venue allows it, I would highly recommend it. It's pretty awesome. So this is Arkansas Motorsport Park. This was originally designed as a shifter kart track, and it features a banked oval, a few long straights, a lot of really tight technical turns, and actually a few elevation changes as well, if you can believe that. So we generally enter the track right down here. This is the main gate, and we go in a counterclockwise motion around the oval. And again, the oval's banked, so it adds a different dynamic. We exit the oval right here, what we consider turn one. There's two 90-degree turns here, and there's actually a small elevation change. You kind of go up into the first turn, transition, and then like fall down through the second one. And when you leave the second turn, it dumps you onto the main straight. And that ends in like a 120-ish degree turn down at the end. In order to do this correctly, you actually modi the straight and have to back the car in at the end in order to slow down and make the turn. This is what we call the dog leg. It enters into a 180-degree turn past this little bend, and it's actually the fastest part of the track. We run the track like this. We use the back straight as a start point and then speed way up, using the back straight as a runway to initiate into the oval. We've had indicated speeds entering the oval at between 60 and 70 miles an hour, but the super cool part about it is that right here, where the back straight meets the banked oval, there's actually a big elevation change. And if you time your feint just right, you actually like dive into the oval and actually kind of jump the car. So we're doing this for science.
Yeah?
You want to tell everybody what these are?
Oh, these are some snow tires that are about...
studded freaking snow tires.
That are about 7 years old. They've been all around the world. And well, let's see how good they burn today.
I'm kind of stoked to see how snow tires burn. This might be a thing. They might be better than Kendall's.
So as per usual, I've already broken something. The muffler fell off the car as I was getting it off the trailer, and as everybody knows, a straight pipe KA is not the most elegant sounding engine.
Yeah?
I got you. Give me some space.
I think we found the culprit, Drew.
Yeah.
I think it's a f***ing reservoir cap.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, there's a little bit of, you see the gap difference? Maybe it's not applying enough pressure.
Well, how do we fix that?
Walk me through this. How does this work? Hey, some people don't know how to do this part. Tell me what you're doing.
You spend
Jesus,
money.
Jesus, how old are these?
You spend money and then you convert it to noise and smoke.
Okay.
That's how you do it.
Is that called physics or is that called fun?
A little bit of both. You use physics to have fun.
Carnage, action shot. We have introduced a new air duct vent system. So that'll be a new meme. We'll need a little sticker.
Yep.
Boy. I think that's mine.
I think so.
Yeah, I think that's it. Pretty sure that's it. So, end of the day, all in all, everything went pretty good. I actually found another two or three problems that I didn't really realize that I had with the 240, and we were able to get those fixed there, but it did take time and trial and error and getting on and off the track to fix them. So that's what shakedown events are for, and it was money well spent to go out there and do that. Didn't really have any hiccups, and the car drove really good. I was super stoked with the new bushings and everything that are in the car. It drove much better. But, you know, I've still just got to kind of get used to them. Had some really good tandems in and things like that. So that's exciting. It's a good way to start the year for us, for me anyway. But regardless of all that, thank you guys so much for watching. I know this is kind of different. We're trying some different stuff with the channel. And I really want to try harder to create new, better content for the channel on a more regular basis. I've got ideas and I've got projects and stuff that we're shooting this week and next week and things like that. And my goal for this year, I'm going to try and post one video a week. That's my goal anyway. I'm going to try real hard to do that for you guys, and because YouTube, we've got such a great audience. And we've had people that have followed us on here for a long time. And I haven't been as active on here as I should be. So I'm going to get on to that. I'm going to start working harder with that. But we have some really cool stuff coming up and some really interesting, cool projects that I hope you guys stick around for, because I think you're really going to like them. And I'm excited to be doing it. But anyway, again, we'll see you guys next week. But until then, give them hell. All right. Bye, guys.